is this more evident than in the world of textile manufacture and clothing distribution. Consumers want fashionable clothes at affordable prices. Nowadays, you know, everyone run towards the brand and they want, because they want fashionable clothes. Now the trend of getting your clothes stitched has lessened, okay? And now everyone wants to have fashionable clothes and that too in an affordable price, right? So because of that only you will see different brands coming up in market, every now and then, right? Much of high street fashion is produced in various countries across the world. Business sources clothes from countries like India, China, Bangladesh and Turkey because of lower material and labor costs in these countries. In order to meet consumer demands, Primark works with manufacturers around the world. Okay, so see, they have outlets all through the world. Okay, so what they do, they actually they work with manufacturers from all through the world so that they can meet the world's demand. Okay, Primark is a part of Associated British Foods, a diversified international food ingredient and retail group. Primark has almost 200 stores across Ireland, okay, UK, Spain, Netherlands, Germany, Belgium and Portugal. Primark's annual turnover accounts for a significant proportion of ABB's revenues and profits. So Primark is actually, that is the part of Associated British Foods, that is an international food group, retail group, okay. Primark target customers is fashion conscious and want value for money, okay. Yes. So see, whoever is purchasing Primark clothes, they are very fashion conscious people and they want value for money. Okay, Primark can offer value for money by sourcing products efficiently, making clothes with simpler design, using local fabrics and trims. Okay, focusing on the most popular sizes, buying in volume, not spending heavily on advertising. So see, if the companies are cutting down costs in terms of advertising, okay, what is going to happen? If they don't have to pay much for advertising, obviously they can sell their clothes at a lesser rate, right? Because they need not to take out the money they have spent in advertising through by increasing the prices, right or not? Because see, whatever they spend, the name of the brand is Primark. I am giving you a general example. See, if the company spends a lot of money on advertising, they take out that those funds by increasing the cost of clothes, right? Everyone, KP Ramakrishnan, Sri Raj, Vijesh and Kelvin. Okay, so if the company they need not to spend more on advertising, this is what Primark people do. They don't spend much on advertising and this is how they are able to provide customers with fashionable clothes at a lesser rate. Okay, then they make clothes with simpler designs. If designs are simple, it would be made in less money, and if it is made in cheap amount, they need not to take more from customers, right? And if what else they do to cut down the prices, they use local fabrics. See, if they have to make Primark clothes for India, for Indian people, what they're going to do, they're going to take fabrics from India only for Indian people, and they are going to make Primark clothes for the lab. They are going to make clothes and they are going to sell it under the brand name. So this is how they cut down their costs. And if they are investing less, obviously they'll charge less, fine. And they try to make the most popular sizes so that they can do more, they can earn more. Okay, Primark business growth comes from meeting these customer needs while continuing to expand stores and move into new markets. So see, whatever customers they already have, they try to meet out with their needs so that they can stay tied up to them, and at the same time they continue expanding stores so they can earn more, fine. This is how they generate revenues for themselves, they generate profit for themselves. Is it clear, everyone? Any questions so far? Okay, KP Ramakrishnan, you have joined very late. Today we are doing a case study on Primark, that is a clothing brand, Irish clothing brand. Okay, they are this is an Irish clothing brand and they have their headquarters in Dublin. Okay, and they have their outlets all through the world. So see, they sell fashionable clothes at a reasonable amount, and in order to cut down the amounts for customers, okay, they do these tricks. Okay, so now you have to read it from here till volume, and then we are going to jump to the next page. Fine, everyone? Is it clear? Okay, so just read it on your own to get the better understanding of this. Okay. See, they already have customers. You know, if you are providing good quality. See, suppose I myself, let me give you the example of mine. Okay, like I purchase Fab India clothes. Okay, I have been purchasing it since long. Okay, clothes from Fab India, and they provide good quality. Costs are also up to the mark. So, you know, I am their regular customer, and since they are still continuing with the quality, they are not, you know, like compromising in terms of quality. I'm sticking to them. Okay, so this is how, you know, I am the customer. I'm already sticking to them, and you know, they get more customers by when they you know, open outlets in new markets. Okay, and at the same time, you know, if they are having a promising customer, okay, someone who is taking who is you know, having a good image of them at the backside of their mind, then obviously they are going to bring more customers. Okay. Clear? Okay, so just read this on your own and then we are going to jump to the next page. So they not only sell, you know, clothes, they also sell, you know, like other stuff like, you know, sandals, other stuff. Okay, not only clothes, they sell jewelry, artificial jewelry, sandals, like lot many stuff, dresses, jeans, everything. Good evening, Prabhavati, how are you? Good to see you in class after so many days. Once you are done with reading, just type done in the chat box, everyone out there. Prabhavati, are you able to hear me well? I cannot see your responses. Okay. So Prabhavati, today we are doing a case study on the brand with the name Primark. That is an Irish clothing brand and they have outlets in many countries. Okay. And they have their headquarters in Dublin. Okay. They actually provide value for money. Okay. So they sell fashionable clothes at an affordable price. And in order to cut down the prices, they adapt following measures, which is being listed here. So just read this page and then we are going to switch to the next page. Mohammed Tariq, just read this page. And Prabhavati, you too. Okay? Just read this part and then we're going to go to the next page. Once you are done, just type done in the chat box. Everyone out there. Are you done with this? Everyone out there? If you are done with this page, let's go to the next page. Let me know in the chat box itself. Okay, done. Okay. Prabhavati, are you done with it? Shall we proceed ahead to the next page? Prabhavati, KP Ramakrishnan is done. Sri Raj, Vijesh, Kelvin, are you done? Let me know in the chat box, please. I don't want to waste any time. Okay. Let's proceed ahead to the next page. Okay, this case study shows how Primark sources the clothes it sells in shops, okay, in an ethical and fair way, often at added cost to itself. What are business ethics? Yes, Prabhavati, what is the issue? Yes, Prabhavati, please let me know in the chat box. Prabha, please respond in the chat box. Let me know why you have raised your hand. Yeah, tell me what is the issue. Can you please post your query in the chat box, Prabhavati? Okay, your headset is not working. So, are you able to hear me? This case study shows how Primark sources the clothes itself in shops in an ethical and fair way. Okay, okay. But at an added cost to itself. Business has responsibility to society. Business ethics are rules of conduct and principles and patterns of behavior in business dealings that involve doing the right thing. So business ethics means following rules in business, doing relevant things. Fine, everyone? Part of this responsibility is to look after the wider community involved in business process, including employees across the globe. Primark works with many third-party suppliers and has a key concern to source ethically. Fine? Primark is very clear about where it stands on business ethics. As an international brand with global supply chain, this is an international brand, right? And they have their chains in all through the world. We have a responsibility to act ethically. Ethically means doing sound practices, not doing injustice with the customers, okay? Neither doing, so doing justice with everyone involved with them, whether it's their customers or employees, okay? Whoever is involved in business with Primark, fine? Is it clear, everyone? Just a second, please. Yeah. Now, Primark works with many third-party suppliers and has the key concern to source ethically. As an international brand with a global supply chain, we have responsibility to act ethically. We embrace this responsibility as an opportunity to be great force for good. So why they want to, you know, want to be ethical? So that, you know, they can be the great force for good and they can, you know, set examples for others, okay? Primark is committed to providing the best possible value for our customers, but not at the expense of the people who make our products. So they want to do justice to the customers. They want to give them the best product in for the money they are paying, and at the same time, they want to be good to their employees as well. Yes. So this is how they, you know, they are. They actually have the. They follow ethical rules in business. Fine. This is how they say that they are ethical, because you know they are doing justice to the customers. They're giving them value for money. Okay, and at the same time, they are doing justice with their employees too. Fine. Clear, everyone. Okay, can you read this page on your own? Vijesh, KP, Ramakrishnan, Prabhas, Sriraj, and Mohammed. Just read this page on your own, and then we are going to switch to the next page. Fine? How to do that, Prabhapati? Is it okay now, Prabhavati? Is it fine now? Okay, fine. Just read this on your own, and once you are done with this, just try to, you know, what you have to do, just try, type down in the chat box. Once you are done, just let me know in the chat box, everyone out there. Is everyone done with it? Shall we move ahead to the next page? Okay. How about others? Okay, fine. Let's go to the next page. In other words, this means making sure that throughout the supply chain, Primark goods are manufactured under good conditions and the employees in those factories are treated well. So how do they ensure that ethics are, you know, business ethics are being followed? See, when whenever a product is being designed, it goes through several, you know, like stages, right? So they just make sure that every stage, you know, the quality of the product is not being degraded. And at the same time, you know, the factories where their employees might be working, they should get a sound condition. They should get healthy conditions, okay? So that they can have a good health. Primark shares its values with its parent, ABF. These values shape Primark's relationship with its stakeholders. Stakeholders are individuals and groups who have an interest in or are affected by a business. They may be internal, such as shareholders or employees, or external, such as government or community. Important business principles for Primark include respecting human rights. Okay, so they respect humans, and in order to protect human rights, they will never employ people like child laborers, especially. Okay, and setting guidelines for appropriate conditions of employment in its supplier factory. So they just ensure that good conditions are maintained where, you know, their employees work, where these clothes are being manufactured. Okay. Primark has over 600 major suppliers in 16 countries. These companies provide employment for over 700,000 workers in three continents. Primark is committed to make sure that its partners, both factories and suppliers, also act responsibly towards their employees. Okay? So they have partners, okay? Like in the form of suppliers and factories. But this is not about Walmart, this is about Primark. Okay, now, so see, they have partners like in the form of suppliers and factories. So they ensure that whoever is tied up to them, they also follow business ethics. Fine? Is it clear? Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear, everyone? Mohammed Ali, okay, fine. Typically, okay, textiles are manufactured in low wage, high manual skill economies, such are found mostly in the developing countries. Okay, factories in countries such as India or China may supply a range of retailers and brands producing goods according to each individual retailer's specification. So, what you know, companies do, they don't manufacture things on their own. They get it out, this outsources to, you know, like countries where they can get it at a cheaper price, like India. And it is going to be made in India and they are going to sell it under their brand name. Okay? In these circumstances, the factory sets the same wage rate to employees regardless of which retailer the goods are for. Okay? At least 95% of the factories supplying Primark also produce for the other high street retailers. Okay? So see, companies don't manufacture by themselves, okay? They outsource it to the countries where they can get it at a cheaper rate and they send it, sell it with their logo, okay? Primark works to ensure ethical sourcing in a number of ways. It has an ethical trade director whose role is to make sure Primark goods are sourced ethically and who leads a team of ethical managers and executives based in the key sourcing countries, okay? So they just make sure that if they are, you know, outsourcing it to India and once the product, goods are being made and it is being sent back to the country where then it is being needed. They just make sure that the whole process is ethical. Okay? Primark is a member of Ethical Training Initiative. The ETI is an international alliance of companies, trade unions and non-government organizations working in partnership to improve the lives of workers across the globe. So this organization, you know, they just make sure that, you know, people who are working in factories across the globe, especially workers, they have got a, their life has to be improved because what company is earning is because of them. So they too need to live a good life. Primark is able to offer value and low prices because its business model is based on high sale volume and low retail margins. With minimum advertising. So how they are able to sell good products at a low price? Because they have got model of that kind, you know. They advertise less, they sell in high volumes, and they manage to keep, you know, lower retail margins. Okay, the company keep costs down by buying large quantities of items and enjoying the economies of scale resulting from the buying in bulk. Okay, yes. In addition, retail prices are kept low through lean production. Lean production means no wastage at the time of manufacturing and efficient operational practices. For example, using off-season factory time for production means that the costs are lower than at the peak time. So they actually produce it. How do they cut down the costs at the time of manufacture? They actually try to produce things in bulk, okay, and at the same time, you know, in the off-season, they produce, okay. This is a good for Primark, but it also means factory employees get work and pay when they are might not otherwise have been needed. So during the off season, they are going to produce. So, you know, this helps the workers who might not be having anything to do at that time. At the same time, you know, they can get the products at a lower rate. Okay. So its practices are both efficient and ethical at the same time, right? Is this much clear to everyone? Am I audible? Am I perfectly audible to everyone? Am I audible? How about others? Okay, we are done with this. Now I would request you to read this on your own. First of all, from here till here. Fine, everyone? No, don't move it, please. No, don't move this. This is not expected from you. Don't do it. Once you are done till here, just let me know. Fine, everyone? Kelvin, Sriraj, Mohammad Tariq, Prabhavati, KP Krishnan, and Dijesh. Are you done till here, retailers? Everyone out there? Okay, I'm going to scroll it down so that you can read the remaining parts of this. Just read the remaining parts of this, please. And once you are done till here, just let me know. Okay, done till here? Okay, fine. Let's go to the next page. Now, ethics in practice. Okay, let's do this part. I hope you people are enjoying this case study. A company needs to be constantly alert to the challenges of operating ethically. So it's not like they can manage it in one go, okay, when it comes to operating ethically. They have to keep a track record of that. They have to keep a check on that every, you know, every moment. Because, you know, this is a sustained thing, you know. It's not like you will just make sure, you have just made arrangements for being ethical once and it's going to last for the entire life. It's not like this. You have to, you know, keep a check on that, right? It needs to develop ethical practices and principles that are supported and adopted throughout the business, okay? So they can only stay ethical if everyone who is associated with them. Is my voice okay? Who is not able to hear me? K.P. Ramakrishnan? Okay, now, a company needs to be constantly, see, are you enjoying this case study? Mohammed Tariq, Kelvin, Prabhavati and Rajesh, are you enjoying this case study? Okay, so see, company can only stay ethical, okay, when all the people who are associated with it, they are following the, you know, like norms, ethics of the company, right? Whether it's the supplier or its employee, right? Yeah, it needs to develop ethical practices and principles that are supported and adopted throughout the business and to work in partnership with many industries and international bodies seeking to secure ethical practices and protect the rights of the employees. Prima bases its code of conduct on the International Labor Organization, okay, ILO. ILO is an agency of the United Nations. It brings together representatives of government, this ILO, employers, and workers to shape policies and programs. Okay, the unique arrangement enables the ILO to incorporate real-world knowledge about employment and work. So see how ILO you know designs its policies to ensure that you know ethical practices are being followed in you know business. They actually bring together government, employers, and workers to shape the policies. Okay, so that they can get the real-world knowledge about the employment and work because. Whoever on, see, if the policy has to be designed for me, and if they are involving me, obviously they can, you know, design the practical, most practical policy, right? It should be absolutely beneficial for me, right? These promote opportunities for women and men to work in freedom, equity, security, and dignity. And, you know, when this kind of arrangement, this also ensures that men and women, they get equal opportunities, they have equal freedom, equity is there, security is there, and they get equal dignity. Fine? Clear? Is it clear? Okay, just read this page and then we're going to switch to the next page. Fine. Vijesh Prabhavati, Kelvin, Mohammed Tariq and K.P. Ramakrishnan. K.P. Ramakrishnan, are you able to hear me well now? Okay, just read this and then we're going to switch over to the next page. Is everyone done with this? Shall we move to the next page? All right, let's move to the next page. Raima Code of Conduct is translated into 26 languages, all published on its website to ensure clear communication of standards. So see, they have outlets in different countries, okay? So in order to ensure that the ethics are well known to people of different countries, they have translated it into 26 languages and it is very much there in their, on their website. The Code of Conduct sets out the company's policy and is part of its legal terms and conditions. See the full conduct, if you want to see the code of conduct of this company, you can go to this website. The code states that within supply chain, employment is freely chosen. So they are not biased in terms of giving employment. Okay? Freedom of association and right to collective bargaining are respected. Working conditions are safe and hygienic. That is the part of being ethnic, right? Employer environmental requirements. It shares its commitment with suppliers, environmental. So they try to keep the environment safe as well. Child labor shall not be used. Okay? Living wages are paid. Working hours are not excessive. Okay? No discrimination based on gender or anything. Regular employment is provided. No harsh or inhumane treatment is allowed. Primark is committed to compliance of all country laws. So if they are operating in India, they are even going to, you know, like they are also, you know, going to follow the laws of India. Okay? Primark works closely with suppliers and factories that produce its goods. Okay? It provides training for suppliers, factories and its own buyers so that they understand ethical values. For example, it offers guidance on issues such as child labor and home working in Asia, as well as immigration and right to work issues. Is this not clear?